Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about the topic is civics. The topic is understanding diversity. Okay, in this topic we learned about something. What is this? The first one, know the meaning of diversity, and the next one, develop a healthy attitude towards others around you, and the next one, understand the differences in the belief system of people. Okay, now we are going to see about the topic understanding diversity. From the below table we understand that the three students are different from one another. This shows that people speak different languages, eat different kinds of food, celebrate their own festivals, and practice a culture different from one to another. Similarly, people who live in different parts of our country differ in their ways of life. These differences makes us unique as Indians. We come from different backgrounds, belong to different cultures, worship in different ways, yet we live together. This is known as diversity. Diversity in India. India is a home to civilization that is 5,000 years old. Different groups of people from different parts of the world were attracted towards India over the year because of its wealth. Thus, the Dravidians, Negroids, Aryans, Albinists, and Mongolids become part of the modern Indian race. We will now study the diversity in India under the following broad headlines: land forms and lifestyles diversity, social diversity, religious diversity, and linguistic diversity, and finally cultural diversity. Now, the first we're going to see about the topic is land forms and lifestyle diversity. What is the land forms and lifestyle diversity? A continent is a very large area of land with various physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, rivers, and seas, and various type of weather patterns. India has all of them. India is known as a subcontinent. These features have an underlying influence upon the people who live in different landforms of the country. The next is landforms. The surface of the earth is covered with a variety of different types of landforms. We see that valley, mountains, plain, iceland. This is the desert place. And the next is coastline. Okay, let's go to the topic. The landforms. Diversity in landforms also impacts the flora and fauna of a region. The plant and animal wealth of a place depends upon the natural habitat and the climate that prevails in that region. Food, clothing, occupation, and livelihood of the people is closely connected with the region's natural surroundings and climate. Do you know some interesting news? This is a Mizoram. Mizoram is located in Meghalaya, is the land of highest rainfall. And this is a Jaisalmer. Jaisalmer, located in Rajasthan, is the land of lowest rainfall. Okay. Next, family and society. Families constitute the fundamental unit of a society. There are two types of families, joint families and nuclear families. Families live in a harmonious neighborhood. Hundreds of neighborhoods collectively form a village, and thousands of them group together in a city. And the next is religious diversity. India is a secular country. It does not declare any religion as state religion. The freedom of religion is our fundamental right. India is the birthplace of many religions and has become the home of many others: Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Zoroastrianism flourish in India. The wide variety of festivals celebrated in India is a true manifestation of its rich culture and traditions. Festivals like Pongal, Deepavali, Holi, Vijayadashami, Ayuda Puja, Navaratri, Durga Puja, and Ganesh Chaturthi are some of the festivals that denote the cultural diversity of India. Children, now next we're going to see about our next class. Okay, now we recall what are the things we learned about in this topic. Okay, the first one, India is the land of unity in diversity. And the next one, diversity is a state of being different from each other. And another one, landforms and climate have an impact of diversity. And another one, physical features and climatic conditions determine the economic activities of region. And the next one, diversity in landforms also impacts the flora and fauna of a region. Okay, children, next we're going to see about our next class. Okay, thank you.